But anyways, we want to go and look at, let's switch out this base map here. Let's switch this over to Street Map Google. But you could also work with orthophoto. So what I'm going to show you here is, and let me turn off my, well, let me leave this on for a minute here. But I want to, this is where our area is going to be changing. So what I want to do is incorporate, is that the area that's working? Yeah, that's the area that's working. So we want to incorporate that new land development in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to classify land use, and a dialog comes up. And this will be really helpful for your InfoSwim. But I'm going to go and create a land use layer based on an ortho photo. Or in this case, I'm using this Google Street Map just because it's simple to demonstrate. But if you've got ortho photos and you're trying to say you don't have it classified as land use, you want to classify it, this tool will do that. So I'll go over here, say create a new land use layer, and we'll call it proposed land use. And click on there, and it creates a new layer. It's kind of an empty layer in there. And then we're gonna define what image layer we're working with. Now here you choose your aerial mapping, but I'm gonna use a street map, and I'm gonna choose what zoom level I'm at. So if I start zooming in, I start seeing like houses and things. I don't want to have that level of detail, right? So I'm gonna zoom out till that disappears, and then right click, say done. So that's telling me if I'm working at level 9. So this is called a pyramid file. Basically, as you zoom in, you get more and more detail. And then I'm gonna choose my limits. I'm gonna say user defined limits. Hit pick, and I want to go ahead and just drag a box around this lower subbasin. So I'm really only concerned with this guy right here. So hit OK, and it's going to create a new layer called Street Map Training. And you see that layer just got created. Now there's actually two layers here, right? There's the base map that we have, and then there's this image that we just created. So now that we have this image created, we're going to turn off our Hack HMS layer. And we're going to train the software to understand what this orthophoto is or whatever it happens to be, right? So we kind of pre-populate this with some land uses just so you can get started. But you can easily add more. You hit the little browse button. You could say, well, let's say I got some industrial area in there. Click on it and it fills in the table. Or if it's not in the table, you can just type it in, right? You can give it the curve numbers you want. But anyways, we do have some wooded area in here. So we'll select woods. We'll come here, say pick sample. And I'll just grab a piece of wood. Now, if you're working with ortho photos, you're going to want to get lots of different samples. You're going to, get different vegetation, different brush, different trees, all this different stuff you're going to come in there and get. And the more samples you give it, the more it's going to understand what's going on, because it's using what they call machine learning on the graphics card. It's doing all this work here, but it's using machine learning to say, okay, I understand this part of the photograph. Now I need to go find other parts of the photograph that look the same. So it's using machine learning. Now, because it's all one color, I don't want to do that because it'll just kind of confuse it and slow it down. So I'll just give it one sample here. So I've got some open space in here. Let's choose open space, paint that in. I've got some water in here too. So we'll select water and paint that in. And then I've got some roads in here as well. So I'll select roads. And of course, if I make a mistake like I just did here, no big deal, right? Because we have unlimited undo and redo, right? So I can simply just undo that because we're written on top of AutoCAD. I'll just kind of paint in where my road is. And at this point, I'm ready to go. So at this point, I just say classify land use. And it goes and looks at my image, and it looks at what the samples I gave it and says, okay, I can figure this out. And it's going to convert that into a GIS coverage. So give me a sec here while it does it. So you can see now it's actually populated this coverage here. And if I go and take a look at this, I can come in here, select this coverage. You can see this is actually a polygon. And it says, okay, I figured it out as open space. But you could say, no, it's not open space. That's actually water, right? So I can convert it to water. Obviously, it's not water, right? So I don't want to do that. So I'll undo this water. But it's done that. But you can see it also has messed up. You can see here, like this labels, it got confused. It didn't know what to do with that. So what I can do is fix that. So I'll go over to draw land use, and my palette changes to a whole bunch of tools, right? And I can go over to paint overwrite. And I want to choose, this is open space here, so I'll choose open space, and I can choose my paintbrush size, and I can just paint over the area where it kind of got confused in, and it will fix it. It's done. Now, like the roads,
Wow.
these labels confused it, right? So I can come in here, say roadways, and maybe change my paintbrush size, but I'm still in overwrite mode. So when I'm doing this, it's goofing up, right? I don't want to do that. So instead, I'm going to go to paint clipped. it'll paint, it'll clip it to whatever's available to be painted. So here you can see I can paint in this whole area, and so I'm going to paint in where it can paint in, right? So there's a whole bunch of tools in here to help you out. So for example, if I have in an AutoCAD drawing, I already have an outline for my property, I can just go and click on it, it'll trace it out automatically. Now in this case it don't, so I'm going to have to just draw it in. So I'll draw it in, and it's going to be commercial space, and I'll change my paintbrush size, and I'll just draw in where that site is. So that's I think from my recollection, it's right along here. So I'll come in here, and again, I'm in a curvilinear mode, right? And of course, if I goof up, I just hit the backspace key, right? So it's easy to back up here. So just keep going along here, and then there's a spot where it's going to go straight. So like right about here, it's going to go straight. So I'll hold down my control key, go straight. And then if I want to go in ortho mode, I hold down my shift key, and now it's in ortho mode. And then if I want to close on itself, I just go where I want to close and double click, and it's done. So now I'm just going to fill in here. So I choose fill area, fill in this area here, fill in that area. Of course, you can see along that interface, it didn't quite do the right job there. And we're going to go in here and say paint overwrite, change my paintbrush size, just paint in along here. Paint in along here too. It's done. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do, let's go and close.